In case you've lost track of time, it's Wednesday night, which means it's time for our wonderful wordsmith, Kel Richards. Welcome.
G'day, mate.
What have you got for us tonight?
Let's begin with the capital of Ukraine, because there's been a dispute. For years, we spelt it K-I-E-V. Yes. That's not how it's being spelt now. The problem is the names, the Slavic names, are written in the Cyrillic alphabet, and there's no direct correlation, one for one, between the Cyrillic alphabet and our familiar Latin alphabet. They want it spelt this way, K-Y-I-V. And finally, only in the middle of last year, the American Geographical Names Board changed the spelling. The pronunciation is still a diphthong. Probably say Kiev rather than Kiev, unless you're ordering chicken. But it's definitely not Kiev. It's definitely a diphthong.
Okay, what about oligarch, which we've heard a lot about? What is an oligarch and where is the origin of that?
Okay, anything which is anarchy is a form of government. So a democracy is governed by the demos, the people. They all come from Greek source words. A plutocracy is governed by the rich. Oligarchy is governed by the few. Greek word oligo, meaning the few. And these are meant to be the few people who are billionaires, who are businessmen and gangsters and close friends of Putin. They are the few people ruling Russia, in effect. So they're running an oligarchy and they are oligarchs.
Okay.
So that's
the other word I'm hearing is missile.
Yes.
What's a missile?
It's people who have American passports are allowed to say missile. But anyone who doesn't have an American passport, I'm sorry, will shoot you if you say missile. It's missile. Unless you're talking about mistletoe, maybe at Christmas. But no. Missile is simply wrong. Don't say it. And there are Australian reporters saying missile. Stop, please.
OK, now, in reference to the floods, I've heard the word carebomb after they've mentioned rain bomb.
Yes. And it's obviously generated from rain bomb. So they've looked at rain bomb and they've looked at what people are doing, the volunteers, the SES, the people helping to clean up, and they say, this is fabulous. They are care bombing their neighbours who need help and care. And I think this care bomb, as far as I know, to the best of my knowledge, is a brand new word, hasn't been around except in the last few days. It's just been born. Lovely to see a new word born. And I think it's a nice new word, isn't it? Don't you love
it? It is.
Word?
It's a positive word.
Yes.
Very quickly, distribute. Distribute.
The Oxford says both are OK. Distribute or distribute, first or second syllable. I think Cambridge says, and I say, stress the second syllable. It's more comfortable in English to stress the second syllable. Distribute. That's the more comfortable thing to say.
Love
if I want to say distribute, I won't get upset.
Okay.
But distribute is better.
Fabulous. Thank you, Kel Richards.
My pleasure.
Good to have you on.